Good morning, everybody. We are live, and what a great day this is. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we are going to rejoice and be glad in Him. We're trying something new this morning. Let's see how it's going to go. We're going to do one worship song together. So I want to ask you just to warm up your voice quickly, and we're going to worship together. Monica is doing Goodness of God from Bethel, and we're excited to be with you this morning. So while other people are getting on, let us start by worshiping together with Monica de Mont, all the way from Polokwane.
I love you, Lord. The goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am in, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you are good. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so. Of God, yes, I will sing of the goodness of God. Of the goodness of God.
Sing about the goodness of God. God, you are good and you are in a tremendously good mood. We want to thank you, Lord, that we can lift up the name that is above every other name, the name of Jesus Christ. And we thank you in this day, Lord, that we can bring a message which is pure, which is to the glory of your wonderful name. And I thank you, Lord, that we will not just receive knowledge this morning, but that we will receive revelation from your word, and that we will be touched and changed and transformed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We give you all honor and glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, good morning, everybody. It's so great having you with us on Facebook Live. It is a great day, and it is Mother's Day. So to all mothers out there, we just want to say a happy Mother's Day. It's one of our great times in a calendar year where we come together, and normally GT Kids, our children's ministry, come and they do something special for us. But the only kid on the block this morning is me. So I'm going to give my best and just hope you all have a wonderful Mother's Day. So mothers, I want to just quickly say a few things, and everybody watching, if you are watching right now, you need to know, I know this is not rich, but you need to know that you've got a mom. You might not know your mother or never have met her, or she might not still be alive, but today is a very special day. Because with all that being said, I want to tell you that just the fact that you might not know her, never have met her, or that she might not still be here, it is relative to the following truth. The truth is that God decided that you and I should come and walk the face of the earth. God so loved you that he destined you to be on earth. And I want to speak this word over you. You who are watching, I want to tell you today that God loves you so much. And he used a mother. And we want to thank moms. And we want to thank God most of all because we have been formed and created in his image and in his likeness. And he has a plan and a destiny for us. And so we can live that out in Jesus' mighty name. So it's wonderful having you here this morning. And I want to say to you this morning, specifically to the moms. I want to say to you that if you are not in right standing with your mother or you've never been in right standing with your mom, forgive them. Forgive them, bless them, pray for them. We want to be living free as Christians in Jesus' name. And Jesus told us that if we forgive, we will be forgiven. And many times this is overlooked, but we need to forgive one another. And if your mom is one of them, please forgive her. It's going to be to the benefit of you and all those around you. So once again, just want to say happy Mother's Day. And I hope you've been spoiled this morning. If not, I trust that you're going to have a wonderful day in lockdown and that we will have a good time together as families in Jesus' name. I want to just bless you. So this morning, last night I sent out a message and I said that you guys need to get ready with your typing fingers to bring up a comment. I'm going to ask a question, and right now I'm going to ask this question. I want to ask you, if you have to think of any Bible character that really has impacted your life, it's like a faith hero, let's call it that, a faith hero in your life, I want you to quickly go and comment who's your faith hero. You don't have to put a massive explanation next to it. I would just quickly like to see, what are you guys saying, who is your faith hero? So I'm having a look, and let's just see that when the names come up, I see that there's a little bit of a delay on my side, but you start posting that. And while you start posting that, I also want to say to you that if you've had a birthday in the last week, or a spiritual birthday in the last week, we also just want to congratulate you from the gathering side and say to you, may you have a blessed year In Jesus' name, may all the wonderful things people have spoken over your life become a reality in Jesus' name. And may you, as you are blessed, be a blessing to so many other people. Amen. So, hope you had a great day in lockdown. And I also want to just say that there are people that are in hospital. We're thinking specifically on to Tani Pietru Apple. She was taken up in the hospital last night. We are speaking health and healing over her in Jesus' name. And so many others that might be sick, we are speaking the health and the wealth of Jesus over you in this time in Jesus' name. So let's see. We've got a few names here. We've got Sam Jacobs, you are saying David. We've got Betsy saying Hannah. So, Lean Voliter, you had a birthday. Congratulations this week. You said David. Adele from Cape Town, you say Jesus. Helen Dixon, Paul. Colin, my brother from Lichtenberg, Jonah. Elsa, Job. And then Claire Valentine, you're saying Mary Magdalene. Now, you know, normally we would go around in the church and we would give the mic to everybody. Aren't you glad we're not doing that today? Let's have a look. Paul from Lona saying Paul. Anna-Marie Engelbrecht, David, Jessica, Linda, also David, Monica, David. Well, we've got a lot of Davids here. Larika from Lichtenberg, from Leidenberg, you are saying Joseph. Adele, it's not fair. You are saying twice, eh? Moses. Lizette, my own wife, she's saying Esther. She's behind the camera, doing all the things that's happening here. Let's see, who's what else? Wendan and Tani Joey. Don is saying Petrus, and Auntie Joey is saying Paul. And then we've got Leanne Jones saying God, and Lizanne Brink, also from Leidenberg. Ruth and Mary, please keep on commenting. Oh, there's Auntie Petru. Ruth, you're watching from hospital. We love you, Auntie Petru. God bless you. And then Paul from Jerome Dixon. You guys can keep on carrying on with just sharing who your favorite Bible character is. And you might have different reasons for that, but this morning I want to get into the word, and fittingly it's Mother's Day, and I want to speak this morning. Today's message is entitled Woman of Faith. Woman of Faith. And so let's look at a few. If I want to say to you today that, don't get me wrong, all these people that you have mentioned, they are truly impactful. They were people of faith. They had great stories behind them, and they did wonderful things. But the Bible also includes stories of some great and often overlooked women of faith. If you go and look in the comments below, and it's just been proven once again, you will see there that there's more men being mentioned than women. And it's okay. Don't worry about that. But I want to focus on the women today. I want to focus on the women in ministry and just being examples in the kingdom of God. Just as a matter of interest, if you go and read the book of Hebrews 11, you will find there that in the book of Hebrews, there are only two mentions of two women. And a third one is not mentioned by name, but it was the widow whose son was resurrected from the dead. But despite all that, I want to speak today on women of faith. So I know whether they were leading an army, negotiating peace or a treaty, or serving the poor of the community, they acted with trust, they acted with faith, hope, and obedience. And generations later, they still speak to men and women, young and old, all alike. The first person I want to look at this morning, the first woman of faith I want to mention, is Sarah. Sarah. We're going to read from Hebrews 11, from verse 11 to verse 12. In the New King James Version, the Bible says the following. It says, by faith, Sarah herself also received strength to conceive seed. And she bore a child when she was past the age, because she judged him faithful who had promised. What a powerful saying. She judged him faithful who had promised. Therefore, from one man, and him as good as dead. Just listen what the word says. As good as dead. Were born as many as the stars of the sky in multitude, innumerable, and as the sand which is by the seashore. You know, when I was reading this, there's two things that really stand out to me in regards to this specific portion of scripture with Sarah and Abraham. One, Sarah received strength from God, which was supernatural. And about Abraham, it said that he was as good as dead. Now, you all know what that means if you're grown-ups. And verse 11, Sarah gave birth to Isaac when she was 90 years of age because she looked away from her physical inability and judged God faithful to keep his word. Isn't that just powerful? 90 years old, and she received strength from the Lord. Abraham was 100 years old when Isaac was born. Man. Verse 13 to 16, although they received only a partial fulfillment of what God had promised, these elders, the men and women of old, maintained their faith that God would do what he said because of their close relationship with God. They could not feel at home in earthly surroundings. They looked for something better. They looked for something better. And because of their longings, God gladly acknowledged them as his own people, and they recorded in the book of faith, Hebrews 11, the heroes of faith, and they are both recorded there, husband and wife, both in one chapter. I want to go on to number two, and the second woman of faith that I want to mention to you is the woman, the harlot Rahab. The harlot Rahab, we find her in Hebrews 11, verse 30 to 31. And I want you to read with me there. The word of God says, by faith, the walls of Jericho fell down after they were encircled for 7 days. By faith, the harlot Rahab did not perish with those who did not believe, when she had received the spies with peace. I want to say to you that the word of God says in Romans 10 verse 17 that faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. When the word of God goes out, you need to take that word and you need to mix that word with faith. Every Sunday, every Wednesday, every Friday, every day when you spend time in the word of God, you are stirring in your heart faith, in your mind faith, in your spirit man faith. But we need to react on that faith. We need to do something with what we have received. And the Bible says in Matthew that when we hear the word of God, we are wise when we don't just hear it, but when we do it. We will be likened to a wise man that built his house upon a rock. And when the storms of life came, the house stood standing because they were doing what the word actually said. But I want to quickly let us go to Joshua 2. And we're going to read from verse 8 to 21. Rahab really blessed me. Of all the women that I was looking to, Rahab truly blessed me. We start in verse 8 of Joshua 2. The word of God says, now before they lay down, she came up to them on the roof. The two spies were in her house. You remember, she's a harlot. And verse 9 says, and said to the men, I know that the Lord has given you the land, that the terror of you has fallen on us, and that all the inhabitants of the land are faint-hearted because of you. For we have heard, something was said. The word went out. We have heard how the Lord dried up the water of the Red Sea for you when you came out of Egypt, and what you did to the two kings of the Amorites who were on the other side of the Jordan, Sihon and Og, whom you utterly destroyed. And as soon as we heard these things, our hearts melted, neither did there remain any more courage in anyone because of you. For the Lord your God, he is God in heaven above and on earth beneath. Now therefore, I beg you, swear to me by the Lord, since I have shown you kindness, that you also will show kindness to my father's house, and give me a true token, and spare my father, my mother, my brothers, my sisters, and all that they have, and deliver our lives from death. And so the men answered, our lives for yours. If none of you tell this business of ours, and it shall be, when the Lord has given us the land, that we will deal kindly and truly with you. And then she let them down by a rope through the window, for her house was on the city wall. She dwelt on the wall. And she said to them, get to the mountain, lest the pursuers meet you. Hide there 3 days until the pursuers have returned. Afterward, you may go your way. And so the men said to her, we will be blameless of this oath of yours, which you have made us swear, unless when we come into the land, you bind this line of scarlet cord in the window through which you let us down. And unless you bring your father, your mother, your brothers, and all your father's household to your own home, so it shall be that whoever goes outside the doors of your house into the street, his blood shall be on his own head, and we will be guiltless. And whoever is with you in the house, his blood shall be on our head if a hand is laid on him. And if you tell this business of ours, then we will be free from your oath which you made us swear. And then she said, according to your words, so be it. And she sent them away, and they departed. And she bound the scarlet cord in the window. Now there's a few things that bless me tremendously about this portion of scripture. Not much is known about the relationship between Rahab and her parents and the family. But what is interesting to me is that she includes them when it comes to the salvation of that house. One, first, I want to mention verse 9 and 11, her declaration of faith. Her declaration of faith is the first thing that truly amazed me and blessed me. If you read verse 9 to 11, it says, and she said to them, I know that the Lord has given you the land, that the terror of you has fallen on us, and that all the inhabitants of the land are faint-hearted because of you. For we have heard how the Lord dried up the water of the Red Sea, for when you came out of Egypt, and what you did to the kings. This is what she's saying. She's making a proclamation of her faith. I want to say to you, child of God, we can learn something from Rahab. We need to stand bold in the times we are living in. We need to make bold declarations of our faith. It is not the time to keep up, shut up, or keep our mouths closed. We need to shout it out from the rooftops that Jesus is alive. He's the only way, He's the only truth, and He's the only life. No one except but by Him we can get to the Father. I want to encourage you today, like a Rahab, that you would declare your faith boldly. The second thing that blessed me about Rahab is the fact that she said the following. Let me just get there. She had her unselfish desire, that not just herself would be saved, but you read in verse 12 and verse 13 that her father's house and all they have should be spared. She didn't just think about herself. I want to tell you today, don't just think about yourself. If you are saved and you're on your way to heaven and you have a great relationship with Jesus, like Rahab, think about the people around you. Think about the family members that's not serving the Lord. If they are listening to this word today, and I'm going to encourage you at the end to share this word out. Ma'am, sir, child, whoever you may be, your family has been praying for you. They are wanting you to also experience heaven on earth. When we make a decision and we have a desire to become a disciple of Jesus, then we become born again and we walk this road and we have peace, we have freedom. We have the fruit of the Spirit, which is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, goodness, kindness, meekness, gentleness, faithfulness. And they are wanting you to experience that too. Don't keep what you have for yourself like a Rahab. Share it with the family. Share it with your family. Share it with your friends. Get them all invited. Like Cornelius in Acts 10, a man that was faithful in his offerings and his giving and in his praying, he sent for Peter to come and bring the good news of what had to be told to them. He did something. He invited his family and his friends to hear the gospel. I want to encourage you today, bring people into the kingdom by sharing the gospel like Rahab did. The second thing that third thing that really blessed me about Rahab is the fact that she had wisdom. Her wisdom in verse 16 blessed me tremendously. What happened in verse 16? It is interesting to note that she said that they had to wait 3 days till they should return to where they came from. She said to the spies, go wait 3 days in the mountains. Go and hide yourself in the mountain. Jesus was in the tomb for 3 days. Jesus didn't hide in the tomb for 3 days. No, Jesus was placed in the tomb because after the cross, they took him and they put him in the grave, in the tomb, and he was there for 3 days. But after 3 days, he was resurrected from the dead, and he is alive and he is well. And so what is amazing to me is to see is, you see, she had the wisdom to tell them where to go and what to do and how long to stay there. You see, the line of scarlet cord she had to hang from the window, she let them down, is a symbol or symbolic of the blood of Jesus and the redemptive work Jesus performed on the cross. Wow. Wow, isn't that just amazing? Her wisdom, saying to them, hey guys, go and wait there for 3 days. That's wisdom. Many people, when you look at the book of Corinthians 12 and you speak about the gifts of the Holy Spirit, that there will be the gifts of knowledge and there will be the gifts of wisdom. Now, knowledge is things that you have attained because of things that has happened in the past up until now. But wisdom is how to deal with things going forward. I see that Rahab, the harlot, had wisdom because she believed in a God who has done miracles and signs and wonders for the Israelites. The fourth thing that really blessed me about her was her boldness. Her boldness in verse 21. Rahab did not wait for the Israelites to come to Jericho before she hung the line of scarlet cord from the window. She did it immediately. This woman had faith, and faith is now. I want to tell you, she was unashamed. She was unashamed of this truth that this God is alive and that he is well. And she was sticking to her word. She wasn't going to tell anybody about it, but she's going to get her family into that house. She's going to get everybody there so that when those Israelites were walking around that walls of Jericho 7 times, she didn't wait for that to happen to quickly hang it out. A warrior of persecution, or what people might ask, or what people might say when they see this. Oh, what's Rahab doing? Why is she hanging a line of scarlet cord from her window? What is up with her? Is that one of her new strategies to get in business? Is that some kind of communication? But what they didn't know is that she was saying something out loud, coming forward to the cross of Jesus Christ. It's a great example. Isn't that just awesome to think of this, that this woman was unashamed of the gospel? Rahab is encouraging us today to be unashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And then lastly, I want to say about Rahab, her testimony. Her testimony still tells us today that if we have faith in the Word of God and surrender unto Him, no matter who we are, we can be used by God and to be used by God for His glory. Many a times when I tell people my story, and we all have a story, but then we have history. We have His story in our lives. When His story took place in my life, the old things have passed away. Look, all have become new. The person I used to be, I'm no longer that person. Although it's mentioned Rahab the harlot in the book of Hebrews, it speaks about a faith that overcomes all sin, all darkness, all iniquity, all things that were done in and against her and what she did. God uses you. God uses me. I want to tell you today, church, stand up, rise up, be bold, be fearless, be unashamed. Have a testimony so that people will know that you once lived a certain life, but now you're living to the glory of God. Amen. I want to rush myself into the third woman of faith that I quickly want to mention to you, and that is the name Ruth. If you wrote down Ruth, then yeah, this is Ruth. Ruth, even though Ruth wasn't an Israelite, she remained loyal to her Israelite mother-in-law, Naomi. She followed Naomi back to her homeland and married Boaz, the next of kin to continue the family line, provide for Naomi, and ultimately became an ancestor of Jesus. You can read the story of Ruth in Ruth 1 to 4. And isn't it amazing that there's actually a whole book that is mentioned or named after a woman of faith, Ruth. Such a blessing. The fourth one I want to speak about, I think my mother mentioned her as one of the ladies that really blessed her, is Hannah. Hannah. Although Hannah went years without bearing a child, she continued to pray in faith for God to provide her a child. And eventually, God did. The child's name was Samuel, and Hannah dedicated her son to the Lord. And if you read the story of Eli and Samuel, and how Samuel was wakened three times at night, and we went to Eli and he said to him, "Hey, listen, Eli, are you calling me? Are you calling me?" And what was amazing about that story is that Samuel was one of those guys that's written up in the Bible that for many years the voice of God was silent in the ears of the Israelites. But now, because of a man of faith, God spoke through him again. And I want to encourage you. Maybe the voice of God in your life has been silent for many years. But I want to tell you, rise up like a Samuel and stand and hear the word of the Lord that is speaking to you. Number five, how could we not speak about Mary, the mother of Jesus? Mary, the mother of Jesus. Mary was just a young girl when an angel appeared to her and told her that she would bring forth the Messiah, Jesus, into the world. Yet, she responded to this daunting task by praising God. Then she went about the task of raising him, and even if it meant fleeing to Egypt to protect him. You can read that story in Luke 1, verse 26 to 56. I want to say to you, maybe, like a Mary, her task that she was placed with was enormous. It was massive. It was a massive task to perform. But I want to encourage you today. Maybe there's a daunting and great task that you need to do. And I want to tell you, we need the help of the Holy Spirit every single day to accomplish the things we need to do so that we will give glory to God. And you know what is amazing? The things we need to do, we need, just like we have read now about Sarah, where she received strength to accomplish the task, even after Abraham was declared as good as dead, God gave them the ability. I want to encourage you today with these words. Like all these women of faith that has been mentioned, like this Mary, the mother of Jesus, had an encounter with the Lord and was strengthened by the Lord. I speak and I prophesy over you the strength of the Lord. I speak over you that you will have the ability, that you will have the courage, and that you will stand up strong in Jesus' name. There are many people struggling right now. You're struggling in your mind. You're struggling in your heart. You're going through frustrations that are unheard of, that you've never encountered in your life. I want to give you this word of encouragement today and say to you, stand up, rise up. When all the attacks of the enemy come, keep on standing. After all that has been done, keep on standing. Commit your works to the Lord. Remember the picture of the camel, where when he reaches destination, he lies to the side and he brings off that heavy load that was on his shoulders. He commits that unto the Lord, and then he gives it over unto him, surrender it unto him. I want to encourage you today. You'll get your strength and your ability from God in Jesus' name. I'm rushing. The sixth person I want to speak on, and I'm only going to mention seven. The number six is Anna the prophetess. Anna the prophetess. She appears in just a few verses of scripture, but is a pivotal moment when Jesus' parents present him at the temple. After Mary and Joseph arrive, they find Anna at her usual spot in the temple, fasting and praying. When she meets them, she gives thanks to God for the child in their arms, because he will set Jerusalem free. I want to tell you, many a times in our lives, we have a word from God, like the prophetess Anna, and we know that there's something that needs to happen. I want to declare over you, to you today, don't get discouraged, don't lose hope, don't lose sight of that thing that God has said will come to fulfillment in Jesus' name. Anna had to wait many years, but when Jesus came in, Anna the prophetess was there, and she gave glory and thanks to God. And there was another man just before her, his name was Simeon, and he said, well, now I have seen the Lord, the Christ, the Savior, the Messiah that needs to be, and now I can die, because God said to him, you will see him and you will bless him and then you will die. And after he has seen Jesus, just a few verses before that, you can read about Simeon, man that blessed me. I want to tell you today, may the word that God has spoken over your life, don't lose sight of it, don't forget about it. It will come to fulfillment in Jesus' name. And the last one is Tabitha. Tabitha. Not only did Tabitha inspire others by serving the poor and widows around her, the story of Peter raising her from the dead inspired many to follow Jesus in the early days of the church. You can go read that profound story in the book of Acts 9, verse 36 to verse 34, where Tabitha was a woman of just living out her Christian faith, touching and blessing so many people's lives. And the people and the ladies were mourning because of her death and all that she has done in the kingdom. But Peter raised her from the dead, and that made a huge impact on the early church. I don't know about you, but these women displayed trust, faith, and hope in God that blesses me. Stir me, and it excites me to see how God wants to use us, how God wants to use you in the kingdom of God. I want to encourage you today, and I want to right now speak and prophesy the following over you. I come in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, and I break every negative word that you have ever said over yourself. I want to bind every negative thought pattern that you have in your brain that is not from God. I want to say that your brain and your spirit and your mouth will align with the word of God, and stop speaking negative things of yourself. Stop thinking that you're not good enough. God created you, and he said, and it is good. If God said it is good, it is good. And I want to say to you today that God will give you the ability. God will give you the strength. God will give you the might. God will give you the power. But align your words with the word. Your words with the word. When you align your words with the word, God says in Proverbs 18, death and life is in the power of the tongue. And those who use it will eat the fruit of it. I want to start saying to you, confess right now and say, Lord, sorry. I'm sorry for things that I've said. I'm sorry for things that I've thought. I'm sorry for things, thought patterns, a low self-esteem, a lack of identity. I come against all those things right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And I thank you this morning, this glorious morning, Lord, that we can speak peace, love, prosperity. We can speak over each and every one that we will have the abundance of God, the shalom of the Lord, the all-encompassing peace of God and all His provision. I want to speak it over each and every one of us. I thank you, Lord, for this wonderful day in Jesus' name, and I bless those. And if you're sitting at home and you're watching this, I want to encourage you to come boldly to the throne of grace and say, Lord, here am I. I want to serve you boldly. You just need to surrender unto Him, have the desire. Deny yourself, take up your cross and follow Him every single day. Amen. Man, it's hot inside you. It's exciting. I feel the Holy Spirit's anointing. I want to tell you today, if you have been blessed by this word, I want to encourage you. I want to implore you today to share this video. Share this link. Share it from our Facebook page. Later today, we will upload it on our YouTube channel. You go to that place where you say share. You'll see there's a few icons that come up. You can share it on WhatsApp. You can share it on Twitter, on Instagram, on Facebook. You can share it wherever. Don't just like it. Share it. Be part of this message and share it to other people so that we can get the word out there. There's people that need these words of encouragement. And I want to bless you today. I want to thank you. And once again, to all the mothers out there, Happy Mother's Day. From the gathering, we love you. Jesus loves you. I love you. And have a wonderful day. In Jesus' name, God bless.